Do you want to add encryption into your apps but still struggling? Well, you're in good place because today we are going to do just that. With the help of a framework that I have created, it is called Crypto Manager. You can take a look at the link in the description. Now, Apple has already created something called CryptoKit. It's their own framework, but it's really, really hard to use. I have struggled and I have wasted hours upon hours understanding it. And of course, Googling or stack overflowing all of the crypto jargon. But with the help of Crypto Manager, you can do all of this really, really easily. You can encrypt and decrypt with one single line of code. Yes, you heard that right, with one single line of code. So if you are interested in encrypting your data in your iOS app, go ahead and smash that like button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. So let's dive deep into Crypto Manager. If you don't know what Crypto Manager is, go ahead and check it out on our store. The links will be down in the description. Also, the link for this GitHub repository, the demo project, the starter demo project will also be available on the description. So what you want to do first is go ahead and clone this or download the zip file, open it with Xcode. Make sure that you have it on your computer. And once you do that, you will be greeted with this Xcode project. Now, as I mentioned, you need to purchase Crypto Manager. So go ahead and check out the link in the description and download Crypto Manager. Okay, so yeah, what does this app actually do? Well, let me just build and run. And this is a skeleton of learning how encrypting and decrypting will work. And this is basically an example of encrypting and decrypting a password. And the UI is ready, so we can add in a password here. And when we tap on let me in, it will dismiss it. And it will, of course, check for the password validation. And you will be presented with this view controller, which has a text field here. And we can set the master password, delete the master password, clear Crypto Manager, and show password view controller. If we tap on it, we will be presented with this password view controller. Okay, so basically that is it. It's a plain old starter project, and we will learn how to encrypt and decrypt, and you will learn how easy it is. It's basically a single line of code, but bear with me. I want to explain everything that you need to know in order to easily use encryption in your apps. Okay, so let's just see what we got here. First of all, let's just open up our downloaded folder and just drag and drop in your Crypto Manager. Okay, so let's go. Okay, so what you need to do is just grab cryptomanager.swift and drag and drop it onto your project. Make sure that copy items if needed is checked, and of course create groups and Crypto Manager demo target is also checked. So go ahead and click on finish there. Let's hit command B so we can see that everything builds okay. Build has succeeded, yay. And while we are at it, let me just tell you that Crypto Manager uses CryptoKit, Apple's crypto framework, and Wallet, Square's GitHub repository. Now here it is. As you can see, it's from Square Wallet. Basically, Wallet lets you securely store data in the iOS keychain without knowing a thing about how the keychain works. So it's a really, really useful tool. Go ahead and check out the video that I made on my channel. Okay, so let's take a look at our demo project. And first of all, let me just show you that basically it's just two view controller, the main view controller and the password view controller. And we also have here something called Crypto Manager Plus. This is where we will do our bulk of the work. And we also have an alert. Well, it's a UI alert controller implementation that makes us our lives using alert controllers really, really easy. So let's check out our main view controller. Okay, let's just have a little bit more space here. And yeah, go ahead and check out the structure of this view controller. What we need to talk about here is the submit button tabbed function. And as we added Crypto Manager into our project, we can just safely uncomment these. And as you can see, we are just setting the master password. And It doesn't find it. So let me just go ahead, go into Crypto Manager. And this is our extension that we are going to create. So let me just uncomment all of this. As you can see, not all of the code has been uncommented, but the basic functions as set master password, as you can see here. So let's go back and now let's hit Command B again, and it should recognize it. Really, really nice. So we are going to submit our password, our password, yes. And we have a delete button tab. This is when we delete the master password. We want to clear Crypto Manager, basically removing everything that is associated to this, vault, Crypto Manager vault. And those are the three things that we want to do in the main view controller. Now let's see what we got under the password view controller. Let's just scroll all the way down. And as you can see, we want to check for the master password. So basically what this does, if it checks, is if the password exists at all. So did we set any passwords at all? And if we didn't, then we just dismiss the password view controller. Basically, that's it. We want to have a submit button tabbed, and here we just currently are dismissing our view controller, but we want to get the master password and check it against the text that we have in the password text field. That is really self-explanatory. Okay, and we are using result types. I know I do love result types, so go ahead and check out the YouTube video on results if you don't know what I'm talking about here. Okay, so basically that's it. We have enabled all of the functions in the view controllers. Now it's time for the good stuff. Let's go into Crypto Manager. Now, let's see. Set master password. Basically that is, okay, we got our password from the text field and we want to encrypt it. The easiest way of doing this is just using the encrypt function from Crypto Manager, and that is the first option that we have here. As you can see, there are a lot of options, and the further we go, the easier they are. But I really do need to explain what they really do so you can use it in your own apps. So we are using Crypto Manager's encrypt function with a string of a password that we got from the text field. And basically what this does is returning us an encrypted password data. So how does encryption work? Basically it gets grabs either a string or a data, and it transforms it into a data. Basically it encrypts it with a symmetric key. So basically that is what it's doing. Okay, so we are getting back an encrypted password data. And here we have Crypto Manager set object. Why do we want to set an object here? Encrypted password data on the iCloud key, master password key. What is actually this doing? Well, if we encrypt and decrypt data, we want to get access to that encrypted and decrypted data on other devices with the same logged in iCloud account. So that is what we are doing. We are saving, including the symmetric key, basically the key that we are encrypting and decrypting data with. We are storing all of that in iCloud keychain, the best and safest place to store data when you want to get access them on your other devices. So Crypto Manager set object, and here we have here when we are setting an object, we need to set an encrypted data. So with here we have our encrypted password data, and we need to have a key. So when we retrieve it, we know, okay, do retrieve that encrypted data with that key. And we have this master password key that we have set up here. How awesome is that? Really, really nice. Okay, so before we move ahead, let me just talk about how to launch CryptoKit, because this is how we kind of encrypt, but we need to kind of launch CryptoKit, and that is in the app delegate, did finish launching with options. And basically, this is what we want to have here, Crypto Manager configure with an identifier and a key. Now, the identifier is basically the ID of our iCloud keychain. So that is why we do need this identifier. The key is where the symmetric key will live at. So yeah, it's the key for the symmetric key. Basically, we are also storing the symmetric key on iCloud keychain. So that's why we need an identifier and a key. So yeah, how awesome is that? This is everything you need to know to just start configuring, well, just start CryptoKit. So yeah, encrypt with a string. Let me just comment this out. Yeah, go ahead and launch it, test it out. I'm just going through the options here. Another way of encrypting data, and this is kind of the easiest way, you just grab the password and add dot encrypted. And that's it. You have an encrypted password data. Of course, because this is optional, you want to if let unwrap it and then set the encrypted data onto iCloud. I already talked about this. Otherwise, just use the no encrypted data error that Crypto Manager error has. So yeah, how awesome is that? You just encrypt with one single line of code. Of course, if you do want to have a guard statement or an if-let statement against the optional, you might want to choose this format. And finally, this is the easiest one. It's just one line of code. It encompasses everything that you learned so far. Password, so grab the text, encrypt with, and master key password. This is the key that we want to store this encrypted data on iCloud keychain. And we have a completion. Now, completion is a bool and error, either it succeeded or not. So yeah, how awesome is that? Just one single line of code. And this is how easy it is to encrypt data with Crypto Manager. Now, this is a string. You can also use some encrypt some data. You have the functions there. Everything is documented. So yeah, I'm just using it with a string, but data is the same. Okay, next up, get the master password. Now, we have here, does master password exist? And I'm just going to get into a little detour here. It's all the way down here, does master password exist? Basically, if we haven't set master password just yet, then that key value pair will not exist. So that is how we kind of check for, is this key existing in our iCloud keychain? And Crypto Manager, does key exist? And this is our key. And a completion, it will result in a Boolean value, true or false, or an optional error if this fails. Yeah, and basically that's it. That is how we can check if it exists. If it does exist, then we have some options, of course. And let me just uncomment the first one here. We want to get an object. So we do know that it exists. We want to get that object for that key. We do get back a result. And of course, this is our encrypted data. We grabbed our encrypted data from iCloud keychain. Now we want to decrypt that string and we want to use the decrypt string from Crypto Manager. And we want to add the from sealed box data. Now this is fancy word for encryption, but what you want to add in here is the encrypted data basically. And we complete with a string or an error. As you can see here, we have our result type and we are propagating that all throughout the UI. So we complete with a string or an error. Now, we could just use this decrypt string, but there's also another way. We could just use the if-let statement that I was talking about earlier. We just grab our decrypted password, like from encrypted data, decrypted string, just one line of code. Of course, because this is adding us, giving us back an optional, we want to grab it from the if-let statement. Otherwise, just use the no decrypted data error. Okay, how awesome is that? But there's still another more awesome way to get that data. And that is decrypted password equals, now we grabbed our key, and this is a string. And we just use decrypted iCloud key to string. And basically that's it. If this exists, so this is an optional, if this exists, we just complete with a success. So we do have our decrypted password. Otherwise, we just use the no decrypted data error. This is really, really powerful. And I suggest you use this decrypted iCloud key to string or key to data, because this is also storing it in iCloud keychain, so you can encrypt and decrypt on your all of your devices. It's not prone to only one device. Okay, final note here, delete master password. We just use the crypto manager's remove object, and we want to remove the master password key, and that will take care of everything. Okay, and basically that's it. That is what we need to take care on in the crypto manager. Now let's just go back into a little bit into the password view controller, and we have one button, submit button tapped, and we are getting the master password. And if we do get back, you remember how this goes, if we do get back that password, then we just kind of compare it to the text in the password text field. We dismiss the view controller if this is true. So let's just build and run and see what happens. Okay, so first things first, because, and let me just go into our check master password. Yeah, I just forgot. The first thing is to check for the master password as the view loads onto the password view controller. And does master password exist? Currently no. So we just dismiss it. So that's what we are doing. Okay, so let's go into the main view controller because that's what where we are at the moment. So submit button tabbed. Well, we are going to use the set master password with the text. And we have this delete master password clear. Now, what does clear mean? It's going to move like clear everything, even the symmetric key. So it's a clean start. And just present the password view controller. So let's move forward and let's add in here. So first thing first, if we don't add anything here, password must not be nil. So we have an alert here, really nice UI debugging. And let's add in here something, I don't know. And let's set master password. Set with success. Okay, now what we want to do is just show the view password view controller, and let's just type in here not that password. Okay, wrong password. And let's add in here the right password. And we are in. How awesome is that? So let's build and run and check it out again. So there it is. Let me in. Really, really nice. Now it's time to delete the master password. So let's delete it with success. Now if we show the password view controller, as you can see, it dismisses it. And of course, because it checks for the master password existence. And because it doesn't exist, we don't have to show that. Let's set the master password again. I will just set it to 1, set master password. That is a really strange password, but it just saved it. And let's show, and let's just go in, and then let's just clear the crypto manager. Okay, everything has been cleared. Now we can show. There it is. How awesome is that? Again, do check this out on different devices with a same iCloud account, and you will see how awesome is that. So that is how easy it is to use Crypto Manager to encrypt and decrypt data, also using a special power of Crypto Manager, like sharing all of this in iCloud keychain. And go ahead and check out the link in the description where you can purchase Crypto Manager. And I hope you really are going to like this and use it in your project. It saved me a ton of time. I hope it will save you too. Now that was easy, wasn't it? Adding encryption and decryption into your iOS apps with one single line of code. Now, if you did like Crypto Manager, go ahead and check out the link in the description where you can purchase it. And by doing so, you also support this channel. If you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and go ahead and check out my other videos as well. I talk a lot about Swift UI, Swift in general, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.